Everybody, welcome back. So in today's video,
living alone in your 20s with no kids is like being able to clean your house, nobody coming behind you and dirtying it, hearing silence, peaceful silence, being able to eat crawfish and watch TV. I don't know how I'm gonna leave this. I don't know.
Yes, this has been something that I've always craved because I never got a chance to do that. And trust me, if you don't get to do this before maybe you get married or start having children, you're going to miss it. You're going to hope and wish you did that. So before looking for love, before men, before anything else, try doing this. But while you're at it, maybe practice abstinence. Okay, or celibacy. Both, I believe, are spiritual. But hey, if you want a video on that, let me know. Yeah, because I believe there's nothing that beats being single, living alone, decentering men, practicing celibacy or abstinence. Ugh, taking care of yourself, getting your money in order, getting your life in order. Okay, living for you. You know, not having outside influences and noises interfering with your day-to-day. Chef's kiss. Top tier. I believe every woman should live alone at least for 6 months to a year, if you can. If I know in this situation, it doesn't apply to a lot of people. And if you can't do it, that's fine. But when you get a chance to, try it. See what that does to you and how that changes your life. Anyway. Before we get into the video, if you've not already subscribed, please subscribe and let's get into the video.
The biggest mistake people in their 20s are making, they're trying so hard to find love. Don't get me wrong. Love is great. It feels great when you find somebody. However, your 20s are made for you to get to know who you are. Learn about yourself, travel, explore the world. And then one day when you're going to be so happy with who you are and you're going to be so content with your life, the right person is going to come into your life that's going to match that energy.
I really recommend that if you get the chance to live by yourself before moving in with a partner or a roommate or a friend, you do. Life is so experimental. Literally everything you do is a process of trial and error. Now, obviously, this isn't possible for everybody, and there is an element of privilege that comes along with being able to do this. But you just learn so much about yourself that you otherwise may not have known. Living by yourself just really enables you to work out exactly how you like to live before anybody else comes into your life and has any more sort of influence over it. For example, when I was living at home, I'm from quite a big family, I'd go to bed really late and wake up later because that way I got to have more alone time. But since living alone, I've started going to sleep really early and waking up for the sunrise, and I just feel so much better for it. But it's one of those things that if I was still in my childhood home, I wouldn't have had the luxury of doing. It's been about 9 months now, and I'm at the point where I'm pretty confident that I know what my non-negotiables are. And this means that if I were to enter into a relationship or move in with somebody else, I know what I need to be able to do in order for it to work and to set myself up for success. Now, obviously, this is just my experience. People may agree or disagree.
Here's why you should be alone when you're in your 20s. One of the biggest things that you can do in order to get ahead is to be okay being alone. And the reason for that is you're going to have a better job, relationship with your friends, etc., if you don't need things from other people and if you don't need to be around people all the time. Because when you need people and you need to be around things, you need constantly things to do, and you have attachments to all of those things, because of that, you would typically do things that are against your values, against your ethics, in order to not have that feeling of being alone. And so if you can learn to be alone, that'll give you a big strategic advantage to a lot of people. So something I did is I took an internship that was at this resort in the middle of the woods, and I lived like 3/4 of a mile from the actual resort, and there was no cell service and it was terrible Wi-Fi, and honestly it was really uncomfortable. I didn't want to be alone. But the funny thing is, within just a couple of days, the feeling goes away. A lot of people spend their whole life running from this feeling of wanting to not be alone. The reality is, if you just let yourself feel it, even just for a few days, it quickly goes away.
Personally, I feel like one of the best things you could do for yourself as a young adult is to have an apartment on your own for like a year or two. I moved into into this beauty like 2 years ago by myself, and it was just a really transformative time. I feel like, especially as young women, you spend so much of your time looking and caring after other people, which is like what it is. It's just how it's going to work. But it's great to also have your own space to just do the things that you want to do and cultivate your own interests. I moved in here after helping my mom get through breast cancer, like during COVID. And at first I felt really guilty about it, because I'm like, oh my God, I'm just leaving sis, even though sis is okay. But then I was like, sometimes it's also okay to put yourself first. You know what I mean? And now, 2 years later, I'm about to move into another bigger, better apartment with my boo. And I'm just like reflecting on it, like, wow, this was such a great era. It has to die now, but it was really great. I had a blast. You should do it too.
2024, let's normalize solo dates. Let's normalize falling in love with ourselves. Let's normalize just experiencing life and just shit ourselves. Like, you don't have to wait on somebody to do anything. You don't have to wait on nobody to go on a trip with you. You ain't got to wait on nobody to go on a lunch date with you. You ain't got to wait on nobody to take you on a date. You ain't got to wait on nobody to buy you no flowers. You ain't got to wait on nobody to go to the movies with. Just go with yourself. You got to date yourself. You got to romanticize your life, because if you don't, you're going to be expecting somebody else to do it. And guess how long you're going to be waiting for fucking ever until you find that right person. So you are the right person.
No, because you can't convince me that living alone isn't the best thing in the world. I was just on a 2-week long vacation and I came home to my empty apartment, and it was exactly the way that I left it. There is nothing that drives me more insane as an OCD human being than when you leave and come home when you have a roommate or you live with a man and your things are like not where you left them. There's a mess. Like, please, I can't. But when you live alone, you get to have your cute girly apartment, and when you leave and come back, it's exactly how you left it. The sheets are clean, the counters are clean, nothing is out of place. Everything is just chef's kiss. So if you need a reason to live alone, let this be your reason.
I'm starting a series called Things I've Learned About Living Alone as a 20-something-year-old girl. For context, I'm newly single, I have no roommates, and I'm navigating living alone for the first time. Today, I wanted to talk about safety tips and things I do and do not do in order to stay safe as a young woman living alone in downtown Toronto.
So my first tip is I never ever follow the same routine every morning. This means in the morning I leave my house at different times, I come back at different times, and I take different routes to get to and where I'm going. Because if someone really wanted to and they saw you a couple times a week, they could easily start to figure out your routine of when you're leaving your apartment, when you're coming in, and they can quickly pick up on the fact that you live alone. Number two is I never ever open my apartment door. I live in a building that has key fob access to get all the way up to your floor. So if I hear a knock at my door, it needs to be someone that I'm expecting to have made their way up. I meet all my food delivery guys downstairs in the lobby. And if there's ever a random knock on my door, I do not answer it. If it's important, someone will text me or call me or leave a message. The third is that I have my location shared with multiple friends. If I'm going on dates or meeting new people, I let my friends know and give them as much information as I can about the person before I go on the date. The fourth is that I avoid places with no surveillance. So for me, that definitely means the stairwell of my building, any back alleyways. Because I live alone and there's no accountability for if I go and disappear, I think it's really important to know where there is surveillance, to know where you are at all times. And the last one is to stay aware. So for me, that means no headphones when I'm walking, definitely no noise-canceling headphones. When I'm waiting for the subway, I always stay against the wall as far from everyone as I possibly can. And if I'm walking on the side of a road and someone's coming the other way, I cross the road. It's better safe than sorry. Even though I look weird or look dramatic, I'd rather do that than, you know, risk getting attacked.
It definitely sucks that this is something women have had to resort to in order to stay safe, but
if you get the opportunity to try it, okay? Live alone for some time, get to know yourself, learn about you, form a relationship with yourself, cancel out the noises, okay? Because it will help you choose better friends, choose better partners, because you'll know what you want. After all of this, dedicate those years to yourself. A lot of people are so afraid to live by themselves. Okay, I used to be one of those girls, so afraid to live alone. I never wanted to be alone because I've always been alone, and I was so afraid of being alone for a while. It was quite later on in my life that I realized that I was just running from me. I was running from myself, okay? And when I understood that, it made a lot of things make sense to me, okay? I wasn't afraid of being alone. I was just afraid of myself. So think about that deeply and try it. Because to me, that's the best gift you can give to yourself. And also, besides all the spiritual stuff, right? It helps you to plan your life, okay? It helps you to make better financial decisions, okay? Because you ain't got anyone to fall onto. It helps you become more independent, okay? And learn to live by yourself, okay? So that you don't need people all the time, because you are not attached to them, like the other lady said. Because if you convince yourself that you need this man or girlfriend or this to survive, you always be attached to people who do not serve you. But it'll help you get your finances in order, because you have bills to pay, okay? And it'll help you maybe eat better. Imagine you wanted to lose weight. You know, you don't have to come home to your mom preparing something else. You just go and get the fridge cleared out and start juicing if that's what you want to do. You start water fasting. You know, you live on your own terms. And I feel like that is powerful. And every woman in their early 20s, late 20s, maybe even in your 30s, if you get a chance, do it. Okay? So let me know what you think about all of this in the comment section. Are you single? Do you live alone? Tell us about it. How has it changed your life? Let us know all about it. My new channel is almost completed. I'm going to film my first video today. So I'm going to review this week after I do a little get to know me. Okay. So stay tuned for that. And thank you so much for watching. Share your thoughts and opinions in the comment section. And I'll see you again with another video. Take care of yourselves. Bye.